The conflict between Israel and Palestine has raged on for generations. The fighting we see in 2021 is over the same issues and hatred born of 100 years of struggle. So, how did it start? Well, after the Ottoman Empire was defeated in World War I, Britain took control of the area known as Palestine, a strip of land between the River Jordan and the Mediterranean Sea. Back then, it was occupied by an Arab majority and a Jewish minority. The international community tasked Britain with setting up a, quote, national home for Jewish people in Palestine. But both the Jews and Arabs claimed that historical Palestine was their land. You can see how that will become an issue. From the 20s to the 40s, many Jewish people fled to Palestine to escape persecution and the atrocities of the Holocaust. But that only incited the Arab population living there. Violence between the Jews, Arabs and against the Brits escalated. So, in 1947, the United Nations voted for Palestine to be split into separate Jewish and Arab states. Jerusalem, a holy land for both, would become an international city. Jewish leaders embraced the plan, but the Arab leaders did not. So began a stalemate. In 1948, the Brits realized the problem couldn't be solved by them, so they left. And Jewish leaders declared the creation of the State of Israel, with the backing of then US President Harry Truman. This did not go down well with many Palestinians. A war broke out, with neighboring Arab countries, including Jordan and Egypt, joining the fight, the beginning of the Arab-Israeli conflict. It was catastrophic for Palestinians. Hundreds of thousands fled. By the time fighting ended the following year, Israel controlled most of the land. Jordan, siding with the Palestinians, occupied land which became known as the West Bank, while Egypt occupied Gaza. Jerusalem was divided between Israeli forces in the west and Jordanian forces in the east. Crucially, there was never a peace agreement. Each side blamed the other. War would continue for decades. Fast forward to June 5, 1967, the beginning of the Six-Day War. Now, this is significant because the map was again redrawn. Israel captured and occupied the West Bank, the Gaza Strip, and other Arab territories. The thing is, most Palestinian refugees and their descendants live in Gaza and the West Bank. Neither they nor their descendants have been allowed by Israel to return to their homes. Israel says this would overwhelm the country and threaten its existence as a Jewish state. Now, Israel still occupies the West Bank, and even though it pulled out of Gaza, the UN still recognizes that land as occupied territory. Following? Okay, now let's look at Jerusalem. It's one of the holiest lands on earth for Christians, Jews, and Muslims. Israel claims the whole city as its capital, but Palestine claims East Jerusalem is the capital of its future state. For the past 50 years, Israel has built settlements in Jerusalem. More than 600,000 Jews now live there, but the Palestinians say that's illegal under international law. There have been numerous attempts at peace over the decades, starting in 1979 and culminating in the 90s in Oslo. Palestinian and Israeli leaders met and negotiated a two-state solution. Initial promise and optimism gave way to anger and distrust, and by 2000, violence again erupted. By 2008, the prospects of peace had taken a severe hit. The most recent peace plan came from Donald Trump in January 2020. Israeli PM Benjamin Netanyahu said it was, quote, deal of the century, but the Palestinians scoffed at it, saying it was one-sided. So tensions remained incredibly high, particularly in East Jerusalem, Gaza, and the West Bank. Since 2007, Gaza has been ruled by a Palestinian militant group called Hamas, which has battled Israel countless times. Palestinians say they're suffering because of Israeli actions and restrictions. Israel says it's only acting to protect itself from Palestinian violence. It is endless. But things really kicked off in mid-April 2021, the start of the holy Muslim month of Ramadan. There were daily, violent clashes between Israeli police and Palestinians. And scenes like this. Forced eviction of Palestinian families in East Jerusalem, which inflamed the situation. In the neighborhood of Sheikh Jarrah, an Israeli man with a thick New York accent is filmed occupying the backyard of a Palestinian woman's home.
Yaakov, you know this is not your house.
Yes, but if I go, you don't go back. So what's the problem? Why are you yelling at me? I didn't do this.
But you...
It's easy to yell at me, but I didn't do this.
You are stealing my house.
And if I don't steal it, someone else is going
to
steal it.
No one is allowed to steal it, Yanni.
And then this. Israel unleashed devastating airstrikes on Gaza, while Hamas countered with hundreds of rockets fired back at Israel. As has so often been the case, conflicting claims over Jerusalem is at the emotional core of this conflict. Egypt and other surrounding nations tried to broker peace, but as always, for peace to be agreed, both sides need to resolve complex, deep-seated issues. And until that happens, it's hard to see an end to this endless conflict.